The political leadership of Kampala Capital City Authority, led by the Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago, today appeared before the Parliamentary Committee of Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises, COSASE, to respond to queries raised by the Auditor General's report of the financial year ended June 2022. Lukwago started by expressing concerns with the accountability of 228 billion shillings, which was spent on procurement of ambulances. He told the committee that they had budgeted for 150 billion shillings, but it was inflated to 228 billion without their notice.
No query that they are circumventing the council to revise even the budget. If you have people who can sit and revise a budget, who can do environments can be done, shifting money from one vote to another, abolishing even a revenue stream, that this one is abolished. If you may dig in, you'll even go to the presidential directives.
The committee was shocked to establish that KCCA has no inventory register for its assets, which has facilitated increased cases of encroachment and grabbing of public land in the city.
Complete recording of land in the land register affects the entity's ability to track and monitor all of its land. That's the Auditor General. And also talks about land not being titled and all of that. Yeah? So for such as it is captured here, the Lord Mayor and team are giving us that additional information. We shall task the accounting office. How much of your land can you account for?
Mission a special audit on KCCA land, a standalone audit, so that we deal with it exhaustively. If this committee can help us, because I raised it some time back at KCCA, can we have a special audit?
Lukwago also disclosed to the committee that KCCA is choking on arrears amounting to 4 billion shillings, which has accrued from non-remittances of pay-as-you-earn and NSSF, which is deducted from employees' monthly wages.
Remittance of statutory deductions. That's URA, NSSF. And the figure here in the Auditor General's report is 4.1 billion. It's problematic on two fronts. Because you see, for URA, it is tax that must be remitted. So it's an illegality when tax is not remitted. For NSSF, it is both an illegality, but also an infringement now on the workers.
But NSSF is one of them, non-remittance. They are paid a little money, but they are also deductions which are never remitted. And this is not restricted to only the casual workers at KCCA. Even the contractors, those who have business with us.
Statutory remittance of the NSSF, where a worker pays 5% and an employer 10%. It's like a pay. Immediately you give the salary, that one automatically is talked of.
The city Lord Mayor asked Parliament to establish a unit cost of road construction to avoid cases of inflating costs of road construction.
Billion Uganda shillings. Each kilometer is going to cost 15 billion Uganda shillings. And this is now where we have a problem. We ask them now, you bring us contracts. This is why we're going to bring those minutes, Mr. Chairman. We're going to bring the minutes where the Speaker has presided over several council meetings. And now we have called another one for 9th of this month.
Lukwago told the committee that roads being constructed in the city under a loan from the African Development Bank have been inflated to the extent that each kilometer has been quoted at a whopping 10 billion shillings. He challenged the cost, saying neighboring countries are spending 3 billion shillings on a kilometer of a road.
Meter costing 90 billion. No, this is totally unacceptable. Then we come to the next page. Kabusubu Namwayaweza Road. I don't know whether some of you have used that road. It is 80 kilometers. Have you seen it there? 80 kilometers. How much was spent? 93 billion, 93.7 billion. Meaning each kilometer cost 11 billion. And this is not a dual carriage road. It's just a narrow stretch.
You must get justification. Even as a layman, you're thinking an average of 10 billion shillings per kilometer of road. We'll need to have a good understanding. What kind of road, you know, construction is this? Because they're not dual carriage and all of that. So the technical team will have to explain.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.